Welcome students, today we are going to discuss about the River Valley Civilization. Now before going to the topic, let us know what is a civilization. A civilization is a state of human society which is highly developed and organized. And when this type of civilization flourished near the River Valley area, we call it as River Valley Civilization. In ancient world, we came to know about four river valley civilizations: Indus Valley Civilization, Mesopotamian Civilization, Egyptian Civilization, and Chinese Civilization.
Now let us discuss about the Indus Valley Civilization or Harappan Civilization through the PPT. Indus Valley Civilization was unknown to the world till the third decade of 20th century. But it came to the light in the year 1921. Archaeological Survey of India under Sir John Marshall started an excavation in the northwestern part of Indian subcontinent, and when this excavation was going on, Indian archaeologist Dayaram Sahani discovered the ruins of Harappa. It is located on the bank of River Ravi in the Mount Kumari district of western Punjab. Next year, another site of this civilization was discovered by Rakhaldash Banerjee. This site was named as Mohenjo-daro or Mounds of Death. It is located on the bank of River Indus in the Larkana district of Sindh. And now both these sites are in Pakistan. When this civilization was first discovered, it was named as Indus Valley Civilization, because of obvious reason, as most of the sites discovered at that time, they are located either on the banks of River Indus or on the banks of its tributaries. But till date, more than 1,000 sites of this civilization have been discovered, and they are situated in different parts of Indian subcontinent. So it was impossible to name it as Indus Valley Civilization. As Harappa was the first site that was excavated, so it came to be known as Harappan Civilization. Now let us focus on the extension of this Harappan Civilization. As we already discussed, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, these two were the main sites or main centers of the civilization. But there were other sites also. Some of the centers of the civilization in India are Manda, Banwali, Kalibangan, Alamgirpur, Lothal, Rupar, Rangpur, etc. Now this indicates that Harappan culture had covered a large area of Sindh, Balochistan, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and Gujarat. We can say that this civilization was extended from Afghanistan in the north to Maharashtra in south, and from the border of Iran and Pakistan in west to Uttar Pradesh in the east. It is called that Indus Valley Civilization was the largest river valley civilization of ancient world. Whenever we are discussing about the civilization, we have to know its time period. Now, historians, they often said that Indus Valley Civilization, it belonged to the period between 3250 BC to 2750 BC. Here BC stands for before Christ era. That means the time period which came before the birth of Jesus Christ. But after radiocarbon dating, it was decided Harappan civilization existed between 2500 BC to 1700 BC. According to this time period, Harappan civilization belonged to the Copper Stone Age or Chalcolithic Age. Now, why it is called Copper Stone Age? Because the tools or the implements that were used in Harappan civilization, they were mostly made of stone or copper. Iron was not known to the people of Harappan civilization at that time. Now let us discuss about the most important features of this civilization, which is the town planning. Harappan civilization was an urban civilization. That means it's a city-based civilization. And the cities, they were planned very skillfully. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, these two centers, they had a distance of almost 550 kilometers, but still there were some similarities in their town planning, and it is true about almost all the urban centers. The cities, they were divided into two parts. The raised part was called the citadel area, and the lower part is called the lower town. The citadel generally situated in the western part of the city, and it is fortified by a wall. Citadel area was also based on a mound, which may have been deliberately constructed to save this citadel area from flooding. Another interesting feature is that all the important public buildings were erected on this citadel area only. Among all the important public buildings of Harappan civilization, the most important one is a great bath of Mohenjo-daro. As we have discussed earlier that all the public buildings, they are situated in the citadel area only. So this great bath was also located in the citadel area of Mohenjo-daro. And from the picture, you can easily understand that this architectural excellence was made of fire-burnt bricks. Now, let us focus on the features of this great bath. The great bath had a central bathing pool, which is 12 meter long, 7 meter wide, and 2.5 meter deep. It had 6 entrances and dressing room. It was surrounded by galleries or corridors on its four sides. It was made watertight with burnt bricks and coated with gypsum and plaster. At the north and south ends of the great bath, brick steps led to the bottom of the tank. The tank could be emptied by a drain, and it was filled with water taken from a nearby well. Now, why this great bath was constructed, historians they have different types of opinion, but most accepted one is maybe this great bath was used for public bathing on important religious festivals. Next important building of citadel area is a great granary of Harappa. As you can see from the picture that it is consisted of a series of brick platforms on which stood two rows of six granaries. Circular brick platforms to their south were meant for threshing grains. Now, interesting thing is that in Mohenjo-daro also this type of granary was found. Historians believe that these granaries were used to store food grains. And from where these food grains used to come, because Harappan civilization was a city-based civilization, these food grains used to come from nearby village areas. Lower town of the Harappan cities were used by common people as their dwelling place. The main street were wide and straight, and in some places they were wide more than 9 meter. They cut each other at the right angle. Fire-burned bricks were used for paving the streets. The houses were of different sizes. Some were big, some are not. Now, this indicates a social difference of Harappan civilization. All these houses were equipped with rubbish bin and bathrooms. Now, can you tell me what does that signify? Yes, That means Harappans were very particular about their cleanliness. This concern for the cleanliness is also visible in their drainage system. You can say that it was the most impressive achievements of the Harappans. Every street had its brick-lined drainage channel. Each house had its own drain which was connected to the street drains. And all these drains were properly covered and had manholes at regular intervals for inspection and cleaning.
Now, from the concept of drainage system, it is very clear that Harappan civilization, its people, they are very much conscious about their sanitation and their cleanliness. Now, this sanitation and cleanliness and drainage system, it's a very unique feature of Harappan civilization. This type of drainage system we didn't find in Mesopotamian civilization or Egyptian civilization, which were highly developed. Now, in our next video, we are going to discuss about the economic, social, and religious life of Harappan civilization.